Hello everyone. Now let's understand something about variables and assignments in Python. Now what actually variables are? Variables are nothing but reserved memory locations to store values. This means that when you create a variable, you reserve some space in the memory. Now based on the data type of a variable, the interpreter allocates memory and decides what can be stored in the reserved memory. Therefore, by assigning different data types to variables, you can store integers, decimals, or characters in these variables. Now, there are certain rules associated while creating a variable. Firstly, variable names must start with an underscore or a letter, which can be followed by any number of letters, digits, or underscores. Variables are case sensitive, that is, both of these variables do not mean the same. Name and name are two different variables because we have small n over here and capital N over here. Now, reserved words can also not be used for variable names. For instance, true cannot be used as a variable name because true is already a Boolean keyword in Python. Now, you can refer to these examples over here. You can name a variable like this, but you cannot name a variable like this, which means that a variable cannot start with a digit. So, similarly, you cannot have true as small true, a true with small t as a variable name, and you cannot have a capital T. Why? Because this is already a keyword. Similarly, you can have underscore name, but you cannot have at the rate name, and you can have age 22, but you cannot have 22 age because we cannot start with digits. Now, let's understand what we mean by dynamic typing. Now, dynamic typing means that there is no need to declare a variable before using them, which means that you do not require a variable to be declared and you can use the variable without actually declaring it. So the variable will automatically will be declared while you'll be using it and you'll assign it a certain value. So a variable is created when your code first assigns it a value. A variable never has any type of information associated with it. The notion of type lives with objects and not names, which means that the moment you are going to assign an object to a particular variable, the object is going to carry a type instead of the variable, which means that the notion of the type does not lies with the variables, rather it lies with the objects which are associated with those variables. Then when a variable appears in an expression, it is immediately replaced with the object that is currently refers to. All variables must be assigned before they can be used. Referencing unassigned variable results in an error, which means that despite the fact that you are allowed not to declare a variable before using it, but you need to assign a variable before using it because unassigned values create errors. Then we have variable assignment. Now, variables are entries in a system table with spaces for links to objects. Variables always link to objects and never to other variables, but larger objects may link to other objects. Now, let's understand that with the help of this particular examples. Over here, we have a variable having a name A, which is referencing to an object 3, which means that both of these variables and the objects are linked to each other, associated to each other through this reference. So when you assign a variable a particular object, first of all the memory is allocated to that object, and after that a reference is created between the object and its variable. Now objects are pieces of allocated memory with enough space to represent the values for which they stand. And reference is a kind of association implemented as a pointer in a memory. So basically it means that A will work as a pointer because it is referencing to this particular object, which is 3. So this reference between A and 3 is going to work as an association and it is going to get implemented as a pointer in a memory. So over here you can understand that A is equal to 3 assigns a name to an object, and behind the scenes Python will perform 3 steps to carry out this particular request. First of all, it will create an object to represent the value 3. Then it will create the variable A if it is not existing as of now. Otherwise, what it is going to do in cases when we already have the same variable, it is going to replace the already existing value with the newly created value. We'll understand that in a bit. And thirdly, it will link the variable a to the new object 3. So that is how Python takes steps behind the scenes. Now, we must understand one thing, that types live with the objects and not variables, which means that the object which is created to reference this particular value 5 is going to contain a type of itself, and this variable is not going to take a type of itself. As you can see, we have a is equal to 5 over here, which means that it is an integer. Next, we have a is equal to su over here, which means it is a string now. And then we have a is equal to 3.72, which means it is a floating point value. And all of them we are assigning to the same variable without again and again repeatedly changing the size, changing the type of the variable a. So we don't need to change the type of the variable again and again. We are just assigning this variable to different objects which have different types, which means that the notion of type lies with objects and not with variables. So as you can see in the above example, we haven't actually changed the type of the variable a. We have simply made the variable reference a different type of object. So objects, on the other hand, know what type they are. Each object contains a header field that tags the object with its type. Now, objects are garbage collected. Whenever a name is assigned to a new object, the space held by the prior object is reclaimed if it is not referenced by any other object or any other name. This automatic reclamation of object space is known as garbage collection. Now, how is garbage collection happening over here? Firstly, we assign the value 5 to this variable a, and then we assign the string value to this variable a. What happened behind the scenes is, as soon as we assign a different object to this particular variable, the prior object automatically got reclaimed with this newly created object, which is called garbage collection, which means that this prior object works as a garbage now, and it is automatically collected in Python. Then we have shared references in Python. Now, shared reference is an extremely common trick in Python programming language, which means that a single object can be able to reference by multiple variables. Now, over here, if you can see, in the first command, we give the value 3 in A. The second command causes Python to create the variable B. The variable A is used and not assigned here. Over here in the second step, we are basically not assigning this variable, because you must remember that variables are referenced to objects and not variables, not other variables. So we are using A and not assigning A to B. So it is replaced with the object it references. A references to object 3. So over here it is immediately replaced with the object 3, and B is made to reference to that object, which is 3. So the net effect is that variables A and B wind up referencing the same object, that is pointing to the same chunk of memory over here. As you can see, A is also referencing to this chunk of memory, and B is also referencing to the same chunk of memory. Similarly, you can see over here, we have assigned an object 3 to this variable A, and then we have used this variable A to assign value to this variable B, which means that A is referencing to 3. So this A will automatically get replaced with 3, which means that B and A are referencing to the same object and the same chunk of memory, which carries 3. Thirdly, we are assigning a string value hello to A. Now what will happen? A was referencing to a value 3. This value 3 will be garbage collected by Python, and it will immediately get replaced by the string value hello, and B will continue to contain 3. Because it was referencing to the memory location which was containing 3. So as you can see over here, A is referencing to what? The string value hello, and B is referencing to this integer value 3. So as with all Python assignments, this statement simply makes a new object to represent the string hello and sets A to reference this new object. It does not, however, change the value of B. B still references the original object it was earlier referencing, which is the integer 3. So that is how you work with integers and assignments and shared references. Let's try a bit in our Python IDLE now. So let's have a variable, say a, and let's assign this variable a value, say 5. Fine. Now look at what value a carries. It carries 5. Let's assign it a string value, say hello. Now if you look at a, it carries a string value hello, and if now let's say we give it a floating point value, let's say 2.7, and now look at this, it is multiply changing its value as and when we are referencing it to different objects without having to change the type of the variable a. So that is how you can assign different values and garbage collection will work behind the scenes. Now let's try to see how shared reference works. Supposedly I have a variable a and I have the value 3 associated with it, and then I say b is equal to a. Now when you look at a is referencing to the object 3 and b is also referencing to the object 3. Similarly, we have a referencing to 3, b referencing to a, and now let's change it and let's say a starts referencing to string hello. Now what will happen when you see a is referencing to hello? Why? Because garbage collection started working behind the scenes and this 3 got immediately replaced with this string hello, and the variable b continued to point towards the object 3 itself. Let's see what it is pointing towards. It is pointing towards 3. So that is how it works in Python. That's all for this video.